So this video comes with a warning, and that warning is I am about to rant, and if you don't want to hear me rant, either fast forward maybe 3 minutes or a couple of minutes. But I've got lots of wonderful things to say about this figure, but I have to rant first, and let me get this off my chest. So first of all, goddamn exclusives, you drive me mad, Hasbro, with your brand new line, exclusive to US targets, did not make this available to anywhere else in the globe, which fed wildly into the hands of scalpers. Stupid. Incredibly stupid. The forecasting for G.I. Joe as a line was incredibly underthought, and in turn, the figures, there wasn't enough released. This was just scalper heaven. I had to pay a scalper, of which I am not happy. I am very, very pissed about this. I ended up having to pay, probably by the time I finally got it in my hand, about the best part of 100 and something US dollars for this thing. So I'm doubly pissed. So that's why I'm allowed the rant, I think. The final thing is, this bike and this figure, could have got two packaging to one for the size of it. It is ridiculously oversized, and I think from a kind of ecology point of view, they need to look at reducing the packaging in some shape, size, or form. You can still have a display, but just, I mean, it's ridiculous. It is nearly 16 inches long and 9 inches. You just don't need as much box space. Okay, had my run of a price, had my run of a bloody exclusives, had my run of a cost and the size of the packaging. I have nothing but praise for this figure now. There you go. I'm happy now. Link to buy it in the description on eBay, because you have nowhere else to buy it, is there. But it's a great, great figure. There's a lot of good promise in this figure and a lot of nice things to say about it. So let's quickly get a look at the packaging. We get some nice artwork, on the box itself of Baroness there and her little weird coil weapon, which I do like, very space age. Baroness with Cobra coil, and again, that damn Cobra Island target, damn exclusive. Anyway, inside the box, there's some of this Cobra Island here, which maybe, I don't know, we get some playsets or something one day. Number 13 in the line that it's named for, which is a shame because it doesn't really fit in with the other 6-inch figures at all. There's all their kind of weapons coding, which I've talked about before. The UPC, which, good luck in finding one. And on the back is this massive Cobra Island map, which again, they've not really touched on too much. I haven't heard any more. If anybody knows really more about this decoding and what's going on about this, I'd love to know. But it's kind of not really been discussed about too much. G.I. Joe Classified is up there, and the giant Cobra logo. Have I covered everything? I have covered everything. We get the artwork again on the side, and it's very nice, very vaporware. And she's beautiful, and she really is a very cool and good-looking figure. Let's get a look at her first and foremost, and just put some detail on this. Let me zoom in here for you just a little bit. She's stunning. She's absolutely stunning. The sculpt is beautiful. Really captured her well. If you've ever watched any of my Vintage Collection 3.75 Star Wars reviews, there was a figure, she was a bounty hunter, a Mandalorian, and in the trailer she just looked so amazing, and Hasbro just did not evolve well into the figure at all. It was just a mess. This is just flawless. Captured that kind of beauty at the comics, that kind of darkness, but also the school teacherness of this prime that's going on here on her. But the facial sculpt is phenomenal. The mouth just open a little bit of teeth going there. It's beautiful. Here's all one solid. She must be straightening her hair from like 5 a.m. in the morning before she gets up to murder people, because Mrs. Fly tells me that's ridiculous. Nobody has straight hair like that. Anyway, she's got the little hexagon on her back for maybe like a jetpack or something, but nothing is included there. This coil is a bit of a pain to get on, but once it's on, it does look kind of cool. It's got a nice effect. I mean, look at that shine in the sculpt. It is beautiful, and there's a kind of like a, I mean, it's on the pack like a kind of laser gun thing or something, but it looks more like a missile coming out of the mouthpiece there. It's all one, but beautiful silver, lovely touches of gold, gorgeous sculpt. Love it. Really, really nice. It's absolutely batso insane. but it really suits her, and it just goes with the whole crazy theme, and it works. It really does work. Look at the detail on that sculpt. Fabulous sculpt as usual, and in this case the paint has accentuated it beautifully, so really nicely done. Facial sculpt, brilliant, as we said. Coil weapon, beautiful. Comes with also a little cobra knife, and again it's beautifully done. Let me just try and focus on that sculpt again. Phenomenal. Paint's kind of filled it in a little bit, but it's still coming through strong. It looks really nice. I think silver would have worked better there personally, but there you go. And there's no silver on the handle, which is not the end of the world. That's a kind of weird black knife. I guess you get them too. And that fits into this holster on the side, which kind of actually is well done, that it just slides onto the thigh boot there and just kind of sits in that groove, so it stops it. You know, sometimes in Marvel Legends figures, when they're, you know, they have nothing on them, no armor on their legs, it just slides up and down, but this works really well. She's got nice little touches on her feet too, little buckles going on there. Sculpts in the boot is nicely done too. Everything about her is really nice. I love this kind of black tone, then a kind of blackish gray, and then this Kevlar-like fabric suit. It's beautiful. The belt just, I mean, somebody made a bit of an arse of that one, but there we go. I'll maybe be able to touch that up later on. That was a bit of a disaster. An attempt was made, but not a very good one. But there you go. Lots of nice detail on the body. The chesticles, it works well there with the armor and the cobra sign. Looks good. That's matched well. And it's just really nice. She's got also some really nice touches I've got to show you on these shoulders. Look at that. So cool. Little cobras on the shoulders. That's awesome. I love that little touch there. See that? Just the way the little design is done there. On the forearms too. Oh, this has been a little bit splodgy-wodgy too. Good God. Yeah, a little bit annoying when I paid so much goddamn money for this. Never mind. Two weapons on the back, and I love this. I love this holster here. I love this difference as well. They've got a kind of, I don't know how you would describe it. I can't really describe it. It's kind of weirdly super matte, flat kind of holster. In that, some really gorgeous, chunky weapons. Really nicely, both kind of slightly space-agey but, and modern, but not. You know, not kind of crazy-ass Buck Rogers, Flash Gordon-like stuff, but still, there's a kind of vibe going on there that I like. It's really, really nice. Two of them, and they slot in really nicely into the holsters there on the side, on the back of her butt. Bit of Baroness bottom for you. And she just looks fabulous. She looks really good. I would have loved to have seen a little bit of paint on that belt. It would have just popped out more, especially that just disaster there. But she's fabulous. She is fabulous. Glasses cannot be removed. But what you can do is pop off carefully. And I'm not going to do it properly. I think I'm going to crush your glasses. Yeah, it's not going to be the easiest one to get off. Ah, there we go. Jesus. You have the swap-out helmet, which again has got that nice flat mat, and then with the black shine and silver. And if we pop that on the head, kind of slides on. There you go, Baroness is ready to go on her bike. All right, so that's the main figure. Quickly, very quickly, articulation, ball joint on the head up at the top. You've got a rocking kind of piece for the neck, which sits in there too, so you get extra articulation to sway back and forth. Her arms are a little bit limited by these shoulder pads, but they do splay out a little bit, and you get a butterfly joint up at the top there, plus bicep at the swivel. You've got single joints at the elbow, and they're not great though, sadly. They're kind of crap, which is a real shame, because otherwise she's just a stunning figure, sculpting design wise. A little bit crap on the arms, but not bad, not terrible. She's got a nice groovy upper kind of ab crunch, waist articulation, not really that great, but it's kind of limited because of all the crap around her belt. But it's nicely done, and that belt sits down and kind of holds everything in place. If you squish it down, you'll get pegs up at the top of the thighs, thigh joint, to, yep, swivel, single, sorry, double joints at the knees and rocking ankles and pickles. She's gorgeous. Really great figure. Really, really good. All right, onto the bike very, very quickly. So the bike is excessively big. I mean, absolutely ridiculously big. It just, it's actually truly designed. I mean, you're going to get to see this bike again. I guarantee you Snake Eyes will be on this bike at some point, or Storm Shadow. She's just a little bit too big for it, and I think it's because she is obviously a female character, and she's a little bit smaller in frame. If you look at it with this, this is a Snake Eyes body. I was going to pop on, sorry, a Storm Shadow body. If I pop this on, you'll see it's much more proportioned to a kind of male size body than her. But just to be thorough, we'll put her on it. It's a bit of a pain to do, but we'll get it on. So let's just get that and get the legs, just to show you the scale of it. She can really splay out to get on the bike properly. And she can kind of, I'm not going to fart around to get it right on the bike, but she's just that little bit too fine and small for the bike. The bike's huge. Really, really huge and chunky. And that's what I loved about it in some ways. It reminded me of Akira. It is really, really big for her. And you could get two or three people on the back here. So that's what makes it feel like it's really for kind of roadblock or something. It's just because it's just insanely big. It feels really, really big with her. However, as I said, put Snake Eyes or Storm Shadow in this case on that, and the frame of a larger male G.I. Joe classified figure really works well and kind of feels a bit more balanced in terms of the style of it. So, what about this bike? Well, it's both slightly disappointing, but not in a kind of like fatal, terrible way. It's just paint. It's just lacking some paint. So they've given us some silver on part of the kind of chassis. We do have also these removable weapons which plug in. She can hold these quite well, actually. So they can be displayed and they fit quite well in her scale. So you can imagine that, because just literally swapped out as a weapon there. So they're pretty good. And what she could do, you could actually have her one pegged on her back. So it makes it even more weaponed up, and that's kind of cool. I kind of like that. Sadly, though, there is no detail on them. Well, there is detail there, but there's nothing picked up by paint. So it's very flat, very shiny, and nothing else going on, which is a real shame because, yeah, she's just, everything about the figure and the bike looks really cool. And again, there's two of these weapons, and you can see them plugged into the side of the bike in that, whoops, in that slot. In there. Guarantee you'll get this bike again. You will see this again, and it's got some kind of articulation going on at the front of the bike. As I turn the wheels, you can turn the handlebars. The handlebars have a bit of articulation in them, in the kind of stem of the handle. You can move that around. This I don't think intentionally moves, but it does. So kind of weird. There's not really any suspension in it, but the tires are chunky as. It's got a kickstand, which is absolutely needed. It kind of, actually, did it stand the last time? Yeah, it did, actually. It stood. No, it wasn't too bad. But it's got a kickstand there. Got peg holes on the foot pedal. What else can I tell you about it? Just really, really nice details. The exhausts are there. So the issue, really, and it's a small one, is the just maybe not enough detail picked up the paint, and I understand they're keeping costs down, but it's a shame because it's so cool, it's so nicely designed, just not quite finished off as good as it could be. It's a bit of a shame. I think older G.I. Joe would have had a bit more love put into it, but it's such a cool design, it just needs a bit more. Maybe if the wheels had been silver or something, just to kind of pop them out a little, just add a little bit more detail, or the exhaust at the back, or brush up this piece here just to show off the little metallic looking little kind of screws or studs. The seat's nicely done, but it's just it feels a little unfinished, a bit raw. But I adore this bike. Akira, very futuristic. I just love it, and I can't wait to see it maybe with Snake Eyes all in black or all in white for Storm Shadow. You know the drill. But it's absolutely fabulous. Great set. You've heard my rants. I'm not going to go on about it anymore. But yes, this figure was worth it. in some ways just to finally get one, but also just what a pain to get. But you know, it's a beautifully designed figure. I'm really glad I finally managed to get hold of one. Leave a note in the comments below. I'd love to hear your thoughts on this, the Baroness Coil, and we'll see for more reviews coming up. Cheers.